now listening to Sleep Time's Over.
Listen up, everybody, as you tune to this podcast. Sleep Time's Over, come closer to get the raw facts. Zach Moore's hosting on the show, for sure. Recording live from July, that's a dope, you know. Talking reminiscing about the good old days in the now. Sipping on that old fashioned at the room at Hi Brau. That's right. Location worldwide on your stereo deck. On your phone, on the pad, but guaranteed all fresh. Reviewing music and the nuisance that the media miss. But got the blueprint with the newness that the people will take. Good old America ain't ready for that island of slang. Sleep Time is over, give a toast up to the rest of the gang. To your tribe or the vibe or the click on the mission. Suggest you dive cause we live on transmission. Listen, he got the voice that got the locals on vote. Zach Moore's from mayor, but for now, lock it in for the show.
Hey. Oh, Sleep Time's Over. We're back. Your guest tonight, the magical Maryanne Ito. I'm the ones and twos, DJ Freeze. Back from Europe, the Somalia to the stars, Mr. Sky Cameron. And your host tonight, DJ Zach Moss.
Time's Over is back. Episode 140 is the number of this one. And welcome to everyone listening, everyone at the Hi Brau Room. And this actually, October makes the 1 year anniversary of recording at the Hi Brau Room itself.
Woo.
So time flies. Show's been on 3 years, but
we haven't been evicted yet.
Not yet. Yeah, knock on wood. And it's October, and you guys are finally back.
We're finally back.
This whole debacle that was European vacation, wedding, whatever the hell this is. Sky Cameron is back, the man that is heard but not seen.
That's right.
For the YouTube people. And you actually came back on this past week, Friday?
When were you? Yeah, Thursday. Exactly. Thursday, yeah.
Yeah?
But still catching up on sleep. So you were 12 hours ahead.
Yeah.
So, man, I'm still waking up at like 3 a.m. randomly.
Well, sleep time's over. Hey.
Hey, whoa.
God, that was awful, right?
Where's
the rim shot? You got the sound effect on that? Yeah, we're going to be rusty. I don't know if we can do this. It's been too long. Kale, the sound man, if the sound's not good, that's it. I don't know, Kale, you all right over there? First time plugging in and knobs and shit? Okay. Fine. DJ Freeze is back. DJ Freeze, everyone.
Woo!
The sound man. The sound music producer, as we say. Freeze, you got a mic now. Don't forget, you got a mic. You got something to say.
I don't produce.
Look at that deep voice.
That's a great bass.
That
good
deep,
bass.
Sexy voice.
Bring it in. Yeah, I like it.
It's what they call baritone.
Noted. Noted. Shout out to the sponsors that are still hanging in. Of course, the Hi Brau Room.
That's right.
Is here.
Yeah,
woo! Right now. Right? Aloha Beer Kaka'ako down there.
Yeah.
I was going to do the thing. Of course, Chambers Wine. You know something about that sky, right?
Yep.
Chambers
still
Wines.
Employed.
Still employed. Congratulations.
Thank
you. We got LMC Media. We got Sakai and Company, which is in the middle.
That's
is in
right.
My front. Yep. The desserts that are provided here. It's the, what is the dessert? Calamense.
Did you say calamense?
Tomato, tomato. I don't know about the.
Calamense sounds like a disease or something.
I got a case of the
calamense.
Ow.
Got it. I don't know what... It's a lime, right? Whatever. Screw it. It's on chocolate, all right? Eat it. It'll be good. So on top of that, we're still on iHeartRadio. We're still on Spotify,
woo!
iTunes, all that kind of stuff, YouTube. And then next week, here's the breaking news. We're going to be streaming. We're going to be live streaming.
Whoa.
So get ready, Fortnite. We're coming. Get ready, nerds. You guys can masturbate all you want because we're coming for you. We're going to be a live show streaming, bruh. So yeah, that's... Twitch, I think is what it's called. Freeze knows about that. Freeze, you play video games, right?
I used to.
All right, whatever.
I matured. Yes.
Elder Scrolls, that got a rise earlier. All right. Warcraft, still a thing? All right. Well, everyone's mostly back, right? Except Tiffany. Tiffany's not back yet.
No, she's still
She's still gallivanting
she's
around,
yeah.
Trying to find a man. All right.
I don't know what country she's in right now. I think she's in France.
Well, I don't know about the Frenchmen, but
sure.
Maybe where's a good European country that's got good men? How's that question? I'll start off this show. Sweden. No.
Well,
you were there.
I was in Stockholm.
Right. Germany, maybe. It's
a lot of tall
German.
A lot of tall, blonde, blue-eyed people over there.
Is that really a thing?
Yeah, it's really a thing. Wow. And they're all, you know, we were hanging out in Stockholm and like the happy hour. Everyone's in suits. Everyone's dressed up. It's a very Oh. It's very, makes you feel like not attractive.
Different if you're hearing this. Yeah, go there. Get some tall blondes for you. Well, freeze you. Don't. That's cruel. Don't come back. That's even more cruel. My goodness. Freeze. Jeez, DZ Freeze is here. Musical conductor. So, Sky, let's talk about what you've been doing. What have you been up to? You were in Europe.
Yeah.
Give us a quick rundown of what's going on in Europe.
Yeah, we did over 20 hours of flight time. So
it's ridiculous.
Yeah, Hawaii to San Fran and San Fran direct to Stockholm. So long flights.
Forget it.
And then hung in Stockholm for 4 days. Great city. It's an awesome city, actually.
Yep.
So highly recommend it. Very efficient, very easy to get around. Everyone speaks English. Great food scene.
Yeah.
It was cold as shit over there. We were definitely not prepared.
What kind of temperature we're looking at?
High 40s, low 50s. For Hawaii people, that's cold.
Right, you get the parka. You can dress up just New Yorker.
So we
dress Das Effects.
We were definitely underprepared for the weather there. And then from Stockholm, we flew over to Italy.
Okay.
And then we're in southern Italy, and it was hot as Hawaii.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah. Ben, can you attest to this?
Hashtag getting sick.
It was hot, dude. And then I had too much warm clothes for Italy. Oh. So it was just underprepared the whole trip, pretty much.
That's rules for sickness right there. You go cold, hot.
And you know what was the shocking thing? We were in southeastern Italy, the heel of the boot.
Oh, yeah, right.
Shitloads of mosquitoes.
Wow.
You wouldn't believe how much mosquitoes.
That's a factoid.
Yeah, I had no idea.
I know that. Wow. So when did you meet up with the Lord, who the Lord is back?
He was gone for 3 full weeks.
I don't know how you did it. Man, you're taking out a loan or something. I don't know how you're putting this off. 3 weeks?
He was gone for 3 weeks, so he's got one extra week on me.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Should we go over there and get Ben's comments regarding?
Sure.
You want Scott, give yourself a little.
Yeah,
bit
if you follow the Lord's Instagram, he had a great, profound map of the whole tour.
So, where was your beginning to end? San Fran to Paris, Paris to Barcelona, Barcelona to Venice, Venice down to Bari, where the wedding was, Bari over to Naples, south to Salerno, the Amalfi Coast, Rome, and home.
Look at that.
Sounds tiring right there, listening to that.
Everybody's tired, bro.
Exhausting. Right.
We're all tired.
I don't know how you guys did.
Everybody's waking up at 1 and 3 in the morning right now.
This is an epic 90 people, was it? 80 people from Hawaii?
80.
80 people from Hawaii.
Right, and it was all industry people, so the industry shut down for like 3 weeks or 2 weeks or something. You couldn't go any place to get a restaurant. You don't go to Zippy's. Schmoke, rice, mac salad. You guys were waiting for me to do that shtick? Fried rice, katsu. All right, sorry. It's a new thing. I don't know how that started. I'm sorry. But then would you have a destination wedding? So the poll is at 50% here. 50-50 still. We have live IG going on right now. So, Ben, what did you think of a destination wedding? Would you do this?
I already did. Yes.
There you go.
You have one.
Yeah, I already did. It was a destination
Shore,
for
right?
everybody else. Oh. We only had to go to the North Shore.
Well, right.
But I think our whole take was the same
thing that
Kale and Chanel had the take on. Like, all right, we'll have this kind of destination wedding. Nobody's going to show up because nobody's come and visit us at all.
Right.
Until we say, hey, we're getting married out here. Then everybody shows up. Everybody brings somebody. And everybody crashes the wedding. It's a good party. But yeah, I highly recommend it.
Wow.
I get a yes.
Dude, 80 people from Hawaii. In Italy.
That's insane.
In this one town.
Minimum $4,000 a person, right here. I'd be like, how is that got to be? For more? We want $5,000.
It made me sick because, I paid probably like for the me and my girlfriend, it was probably like $3,000 a piece, like for everything.
Yeah,
like, and then, but then I'm talking to other people and they got deals. So it made me sick. So it made me feel like I'm not on the computer comp shopping enough.
There's all these guys getting deals and his Airbnb deals and bullshit. Right. And then, so you have that, and you have all of the events you guys did. You guys had pool parties. You guys had the black party, the white party, the gray party. You guys are making pasta.
Right.
You guys are making bread. I don't know what the hell you guys are doing.
We had to buy new suits. Well, Ben actually got off cheap. I bought a brand new tux for this event.
Yeah, I just brought work clothes. I just brought everyone I work in, man.
Yeah. So he got
the
off
outfit
cheap.
You saw him announcing, that's what he was wearing. At the
he got off cheap. So, yeah, they had a La Dolce Vita party. Everyone had to wear black and white tux. A lot of people didn't follow the dress code, so I felt like an asshole buying a brand new tux.
Yeah, you got eBay.
You should be wearing it right now.
Yeah.
I'm going to wear this every week now.
I should wear it every day. I told you, we'll go and eat at Zippy's and I'll wear it. You know what I mean?
We'll get that going. Well, IG story that one. Jane has to be there for that one.
Yeah.
Gosh, okay, well.
So what have you been up to?
Oh, shit.
Did
what
you miss
have
us?
I not been doing? Well, you were here. We did some makeshift episodes before we left with Cavett. We did some shows at the house, so technically you were gone from the show for a week, but
yeah.
So all you guys were gone. So I was in disarray. I didn't know what to do with myself. I was looking at myself in the mirror. Didn't know what to, up and down. And I do have one story I would share. I mean, there's a couple of things I'll throw out there, but there's one that happened a couple weeks ago on a Friday. And this was on a Friday morning, and it was at 10:30 a.m. Remember that time. I called the good people at 911.
What?
So I work, as you know, in the fitness industry. So I do the thing they call personal training is what they say. And I was at the gym of where I work, and I saw this man sitting on a bench, hunched over. And I went up to this gentleman, and I was trying to be like, are you all right? Is everything okay? And he didn't respond. So several times I asked him, he just didn't respond, but he was hunched over. He was blinking his eyes. He wasn't like looking like he was out of it, but it just looked questionable. So like at this point, I ain't got time to play, like Guru said, and I just got the phone, and I just went 911. And I called up 911. 911 answers. And I'd say, okay, can you bring a, can I get an ambulance to the place I'm at? And they're like, where is that? That's what they told me. It's a very prominent, and I named it again. I'm not quite sure where that is. Silence, Then she proceeds to ask me, oh, what's your full name? Okay. What's his full name? And what's his age? I really don't know because he's not responding to me, which is why I'm calling you right now. True story. So then I'm like, okay, I'm getting pranked. Did I call like 912 or 913 or 422-2222? So then it gets even weirder. So then she goes, can we have somebody wait at the street to guide us into the building? I'm like, well, I can't really do that right now because once again, I'm with this man that is not responding, which is why I'm calling you. Once again, silence. There's a woman operator. Then she asks, does that place have a parking structure? I'm like, what? Why? Where are we going to park? Aren't you the ambulance? You can park wherever you want, right? You got a siren and shit.
Bro.
So I'm like, I can't. So I'm in a public area, so I'm not yelling or anything because I don't want to cause a scene, right? So I'm trying to talk calmly. This guy is hunched over. He eventually does respond, and he looks at me, and he's starting to, like, get better. So he then proceeds to lie down. So then I'm talking to him, being like, okay, are you okay as he's lying down? So as I'm talking to him, then the kicker, she goes, are you still talking to me? No. I'm talking to the guy that's not responding, which is why I called you in the first place. And then, click, she hangs up on me.
It's the 911's
911 operator, okay? Oh, true
please
story.
Please, let's drop 911 is a joke public.
Wow, enemy. Let's not. No, let's not. So then, she hangs up. The guy, thank God, he's okay.
Right.
So he's looking at me, and he's, of course, waving down. He doesn't want an ambulance, right? Nobody wants the fuss of that, right? So then, I'm telling him after I hang up, after she hangs up on me, well, I don't think they're coming for you. They want you dead. And he just starts laughing, and we're just laughing. So I'm just hanging out with him to be like, I think they're going to still bring an ambulance. I think after all of this, they have to check it out. So we're waiting, and we're waiting by a window where we can see the streets. So we're just waiting. We're like, nah, just hang out. It's at 10:30. Now it's 10:45. We're waiting. We hear a siren. Oh, siren coming. Wait, this is it. And we're watching it. Oh. And then we see another come. Oh, is it going to stop? It's going to stop. Oh. So then I'm like, you know what? Let's go. So then I just walk him up. I walk up to the locker room. I say, okay, you good, kid? He was good. Walked out on his own. It was all good.
What was the diagnosis? What was wrong with him?
He just was feeling like it looked, it felt, to me, it was like an electrolyte imbalance. Like not enough, like the salt and potassium kind of thing. Not dehydrated, but like a step further.
This guy that was working out?
Yeah.
With you or?
No. I just was there and I just saw him like looking really uncomfortable on the bench. So that it just looked like a shady situation. So I'm like, I just had to come up to him and just be like, you all right? And guy in his 50s. And that was it. And so then he walks out. He's fine. He's all coherent, ready to go. I go back down to the gym to work out. 11 a.m., I get a phone call. Hello? Do you still need an ambulance?
What the fuck is going on here?
Yeah, because Arnold, I tell you, I could have went two ways with that answer. I could have just went, nah, he's dead, which I so wanted to do. But I just said, I was shocked at the call. And I was just like, he's fine. And I just hung up on him, and that was it. And I was just so hoping, because they record the conversation. that they would call me back. I was waiting for somebody to call me back. I was just begging somebody to call me back so I can just explain what the hell's going on. And nothing happened. And that was it. And that was Friday, two weeks ago. So the moral of the story, everyone, 911, no can. In this world of uncertainty, we can't trust 911. So if you got a problem, deal with it.
Yeah, and also maybe have a Gatorade after you work out.
Well, okay, well, let's not take a step further. I mean, too soon. But I mean, just that's the one thing that we got to look at is like for trust, right? We have this number that we know in our heads we're supposed to call, and that is the end all to we hope we'd ever call it. But then when we do, we hope that there's somebody that's going to respond in a way that's going to be able to help us out. And this person, worst case scenario, he could have died, right? And I'll be like, all right, 11 o'clock, you pick up the body? I mean, like, what are we going to do? So that's what happened to me when you guys were gone. Fun, yeah?
Wow.
I mean, there was that. And, you know.
Did you have anything fun happen? Did you attend any events?
Well, you know, my life. I went to wrestling. Shout out SmackDown. At the
SmackDown sold
local
out.
Local people, they still think it's real, damn it. I don't know how. I'm for real. Okay, I'm sitting there, and some people are like, why is he so mean to him? I'm like, this is 2019, people, really? So there was that, whatever. It was sold out, though.
What do you think? What was the mic rating for the SmackDown event?
It's fun. I mean, I'm kind of, you know, at this point, I'm in my age and whatnot. I'm not as excited about wrestling.
Are you checking out of wrestling?
I checked out a little bit, you know, but I still keep up a little bit, you know, but it's fun if you're into it. It's a very elaborate show. It was bang for the buck. It was on a school night, which all the kids were all going to sleep and falling asleep in the chair, so they're walking out. Old people are like hobbling out because, you know, it's like going till 10 o'clock on a Sunday.
You know how old you are now? You called it a school night. That's too.
I'm old, all right? All right? Step to the row. I'm old, all right? So there was that. There was WWE, went to that. There was the Rockets exhibition game, went to that. Sold out Houston Rockets, you know, exhibition last week, Thursday, played the Clippers. Sold out. All the people are there. Everybody IG storing, Emmett. Everybody in the IG story. Everybody's one. I see everybody over there. I'm like, come say hi to me or what? Shout out to the people that did. Shout out to people in the crowd. Shout out Benji is in the crowd. DJ Memoir, he was there. DJ Liger Woods was there. That's right. Countless millions of others. Cher was there. We gotta say at Cher. We'll just call her Cher, like the singer.
Yep.
That's all we'll say. Instagram name. So there was that.
Was there a shocking amount of Rockets fans? Because you've been a diehard Rockets fan for a long time.
Since 1986. And, you know, people wear jerseys at these games, right? So, of course, you know, I'm going to wear my Rockets jersey. And, of course, you got a lot of people because it's Hawaii, right? And we're local people. They're wearing Lakers jersey. Somebody with a Chicago Bulls jersey. Somebody had a Mighty Ducks jersey on. I don't know what that was about. I don't know what statement you're trying to prove. But, okay. So, we had that. We had all kind of weird. What else I saw? It was like a football jersey. Oh, got a Bengals jersey? I'm like, who the hell is these people? This wrong sport, bro. And so local people, it's a pro game in Hawaii. That's what you get. So that was else what I was doing.
So speaking of the Rockets, there's some controversy going on, right? You want to elaborate us? Because I don't know too much about this situation.
But. Okay, well, I'll bottom line it. I'm going to just break down the general manager for the Houston Rockets. His name is Daryl Morey. He came out on Twitter. Which is such a baffling thing to me to begin with. Like, how are people on Twitter and writing shit? And like, you have to be only famous to be on Twitter. Like, I don't know why anybody else would be on Twitter anyway, right? Nobody's going to care what kind of thing you write. So he decides to go on there, and he proclaims that he's for Hong Kong. And they're in a big critical battle with China. You know, it's a very complicated situation. So I don't want to go and delve into that too much. But he puts forth his support for Hong Kong. China is a big NBA city. Right. China supports the NBA heavily. Their favorite team, one of their top favorite teams, is the Houston Rockets. He's the general manager for the Houston Rockets. And he just said, I'm with Hong Kong, not China. Not good for a communist country to hear.
Yeah.
So therefore, they got pissed off. They banned Rockets games from China. They went over the Chinese Basketball League canceled.
And merchandise as well.
Merchandise, canceled exhibition games. They painted over the walls of Houston. Anytime they had a Houston Rockets logo on a wall of a gym, they painted over it. Problems. So, of course, over a tweet, over two sentences. So, big backlash. But in the opposite end, in America, the NBA commissioner backed up the general manager.
Wow.
Saying that, okay, I know we're losing a lot of money here, but we, as Americans, have the freedom of speech, the freedom to express themselves. We can't go against that, because if they did and they were to fire this guy, you'd have another repercussion again, right? Trump could probably come out, say something stupid. So you're going to have that. So I think they did it the right way of dealing with freedom of expression. And they're taking the loss. They're taking the loss monetarily, which you don't hear nowadays. It's all money or nothing, right?
Right.
So it's a very complicated situation. I don't know how this is going to end. I mean, they're not going to fire him.
Right.
But what do they do? Do they sweep this under the rug? China don't play around.
Yeah.
So
definitely not now with that tension right now in the country.
Right. To kind of sum it up, that's basically what happened for the people that don't know the story. So I was just going to put this as a little ender to bottom line. You work for a corporation. Do you tweet or do you say something publicly on Facebook, something of religious matter, something of political matter? You would not, right? I mean,
nah, you're just asking for trouble.
You're asking for trouble. So the bottom line is you shouldn't have done this in the beginning to cause all of this controversy to begin with, right? Even though you can express what you... I don't get Twitter, man. I just don't understand.
So you've never had a Twitter account?
I do to...
You're the king of rants. I thought I could have swore you would have a Twitter account.
You got to have at least a million, 2 million followers at least to just even get anybody to even care.
Yeah, that's true.
You got people with like 15 followers writing something about like, you know, I picked flowers today. Or I went there, I got a bento. I don't give a shit. Nobody else is either. So get off of it. I mean, I don't understand. Unless you're Trump or unless you're some big name guy, there's no reason to be on Twitter. Right. Like, we can sign up on Twitter. Let's create a Twitter. Let's freeze. You want to do something? We'll make up a fake name and we'll write some bullshit on there. And see if anybody even likes it or retweets it.
What do you call it? Gravy on the rice.
We call it, gravy rice. Gray smoke. Okay. But,
well, speaking of controversy,
what else we got controversy-wise?
The Joker opened this weekend. Biggest October movie opening of all time. $93.5 million.
Unreal.
Have you seen it? Are you planning on seeing it?
I am curious about it. I'm not sure if I want to see it in the theater.
This is our second survey of the night for the people out there. Anybody in the house got to see Joker yet? Nobody? Okay, a couple of people. There thumbs up, thumbs down. I agree. There we go. I'm giving it a thumbs up.
We got Jay Nads live on IG live here. Anything, any commentary by any of the people in there? Nobody said anything? Any emojis? Still 75-25. They liked it. Okay.
Because it's been a polarizing movie with critics and people critiquing the movie because it's so dark and violent and stuff. But whatever Joaquin Phoenix is doing, whatever he's selling, I'm buying. Because
it's
an incredible
performance. Right, and I don't know why all this controversy. The controversy obviously worked. That's why the number one movie. So that's what they do, right? They hype this up. Maybe this was an internal controversy that they try to leak out there. Because this isn't going to be the sickest movie of all time.
Well, it's not. I think a lot of people didn't expect it to be because it's not an action movie. It's very much a character piece. It's inspired by like Martin Scorsese movies from the 70s and the 80s, like Taxi Driver and King of Comedy.
Shout out to not liking Marvel.
It's way deeper than you think for a comic book movie. It's
a lot darker. Like you mentioned Scorsese. Like it's a lot darker than the Marvel movies, and makes sense because you know that guy came out and he said he didn't like the Marvel movies.
Right.
And is it going to lead to – that's the DC theme to be dark movies, so this is going to probably –
But the controversy with critics, and critics are kind of slamming the movie saying that it doesn't really have a moral standpoint, you know, because they kind of almost turn Joker into almost an anti-hero in the film. So that's kind of a controversy here because what is the moral stance of the movie? But I think people are looking too much into it. They just got to for entertainment value.
Just look at it like that.
Take away from it what, you know.
It's 2019 again, showing the society's gone sensitive. And it's...
Everyone can be an adult. Everything. We can all interpret the movie
Can figure it out. I don't think we're going to watch The Joker and then we're just going to go run on a rampage and just start, you know, lighting things on fire and blowing them up. I mean,
I'm giving the movie 4 mics. Okay. Solid. It's great, man. It's really, really good. One last... new segment. So we have the Don't Sleep Pick of the Week because we wanted to let our viewers and our listeners know that you're not Captain Grumpy like everybody thinks you are.
No, wait,
actually like things.
Let me tell you something right now, okay? When I say this out of emotion, all right? I say this out of passion, all right? Guilty as charged, okay? So I'm just saying there's things that I like, there's things that I respect, and things of that nature. So it's only fitting we call it Don't Sleep.
Right.
Classic moniker, Cavett.
Right.
Whatnot only makes sense. So the Don't Sleep Pick of the Week, an underappreciated person is, I have to go with bartender out of Livestock Tavern. We go shout out Joey Joyce. Now, this guy, now we got a lot.
Hey.
Now, we're in the Hi Brau Room. The Lord is here. The craft cocktail scene in Hawaii, it's a it's growing scene. It's a very creative scene. It's a lot of different heavy hitters. We got people from Bar Leather Apron. We got people from Pine and Jigger. We got people from Nobu. All these different USBG Avengers, as we call them on this previous show. But we have a this gentleman is a very under the radar, very soft spoken guy, low key. He came from the mainland, worked at Pine and Jigger, moved on to Chin Chin Bar, moved on to Lucky Belly, became the bar manager at Chin Chin well. Then he became bar manager at Livestock Tavern, which is currently there. Always very creative, always very unique when making the cocktails. Because I'm a fan of just the chemistry. I'm a fan of just putting ingredients that we're never going to use unless you see them at a bar, right? And then putting that together to make something taste a certain way. And it's always great. And I've never had a bad drink from this gentleman. And he's at Livestock Tavern now. I think he needs to get his just due because very quiet guy. He's into Three Amigos. He knows every line of Three Amigos, so that's it's good with me. That's a
plus. He also can rap every song from the Fat Boys.
That's not a plus, but let's not talk about that because I'm talking positive. So yeah, he likes 80s rap way too much. I don't get it. But besides that, great gentleman. He is gonna be leaving out of. He's gonna be out of town. He's gonna be leaving. Yeah, it's actually for good.
Well, we wanted to give him a shout out because his last day is this coming Monday, October 14th at Livestock. Give him a shout out. He's moving to San Diego at the end of the month.
Right, so check him out over there. Great guy.
And we wanted to give this guy, his. We want to give him props and give him a shout out.
Yeah, props that he deserves. He's a great guy, great personality, great person to talk to. Very similar to the Lord. It's always like he's on his own path. He's an original guy,
Yeah.
That would be something to do. If you enjoy the Lord's drinks, you go and enjoy Joy Joyce. That's a catchy name, too, right? Joy Joyce, right?
Joy Joyce.
That's like a real name, too. It's not even a street name. It's MC Joy Joyce or something. Oh, yeah, we can do that before we go to break, but we got to talk about the hip-hop dinner. Hip-hop dinner, October.
October 16th, Wednesday. 16th. Next week.
Square Barrels.
Square Barrels.
Yeah.
Basically, we're calling it the Back to the Future of Hip-Hop. Every course is representing a different decade of hip-hop music. So we have first course, the 1980s, second course, 90s, third course, 2000s, then the 2010s. And then for dessert, we're going to do the future. And the future of hip hop is Hawaii. So we're going to have Hawaii artists. And we're going to have actually friends of the show, Mesmer and Astro Guillotine performing live.
Mesmer, the 30 billion artists of Curbside Worldwide will maybe not be there. I don't know.
And we can't forget on the ones and twos, DJ Zach Morris.
Oh, shit. Forgot about that one. Yeah. I got to MC this thing, dude. What am I going to say? Ever hear you say hip? Ever hear you say hop? You don't stop. Am I going to do that? What am I going to do thing? Okay. No, I'm not going to do that. All right. Great. Thanks, Freeze. All right. Let's go to break here, and then let's get things going, because we have a very, 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 very special guest.
That's right.
That we've been wanting to be on the show for quite some time, so. Let's get to that. Maryanne Ito is coming up next. Sleep
Sleep Time's Over. We'll be right back.
Hey, there you go. That's always nice to hear when a smooth beat comes on, right? Sleep Time's Over is back. And news and notes time. Since we're here for October, we got next week, we have the NBA preview. Ozna's back. He's not DJ Ozna anymore, so I gotta keep remembering it's not DJ Ozna. So it's Ozna will be back on here. We'll also have Nick Kurosawa.
That's right, yeah.
Otoro, they'll be here performing.
Yeah, that's right.
Interview as well. So it's a good doubleheader. We got Maryanne, and then we got Nick next week. Then we got going into the Halloween special with Lopaka Kapanui. Speaking of the night matches, blood, boiling, cats and dogs and all that. So Lopaka will be back. He was here last year's Halloween special, and we're also going to have the Lord Flores is going to do a cocktail demonstration. We're going to do a scary cocktail.
Whoa!
Long Island, AMF,
the Bloody Bloody Mary.
Triple Bloody. Rubbing alcohol. Yeah, that's all we're going to do. So there's that. Then we got November. We're going to have finally the Supreme Holly, Flash Hansen's finally going to come on this damn show.
Wow. How and many then, times have you?
I don't want to deal with it, but
got him to come on and cancel.
I don't want him to do anything really at this point, but he's going to be on, and then we're also going to have Terrace House.
All right, yeah.
Punch bowl coffee, desu. Itadakimasu. Sugoi. He's going to be on for all fans of Terrace House on Netflix.
We have so many questions.
We have so many questions. Punch bowl coffee, and so he'll be on, And then, yeah, we're just going to keep rolling on from there. And we're going to be streaming all of this shit now. Wow. Live streaming. So go figure. So that's coming on. The future is here,
the
right,
the future is here.
Right? 2019, yes. Huh? 2019 will be mean. All right. All right. All right. All right. Okay, enough of this bullshit. We got to go on because our guest tonight is someone that very much so wanted to have on. Big, big fan. Singer, songwriter, performer, Hoku Award winner.
That's right.
I mean, let's not forget. She's the queen, you know. What is she? Goddess, you know. Name them all. Latest album, which I have prominently here on vinyl here, live at the Atherton, available everywhere. So let's go. Please welcome Maryanne Ito. Woo! Yeah, we gotta make the air horn sultry. That was good. That was a sexy entrance, but it didn't. Wow. Was it sexy? Marianne, how you doing?
You're
all right? How's the whiskey? Going all right?
It's great. Thank you, Ben.
There we go. Yes. Yes. Oh, let me get the mic over closer. Oh, we got this for later. Yeah, don't worry about this. Don't worry about the Sharpie. Yeah. So, here we are. So, welcome finally, because we're trying to get you on, but you've been traveling a lot, right?
I have been. I've been...
Where you been?
Oh, gosh. California, the West Coast, Seattle, okay. Going between California and Seattle.
Yeah. Were you touring or
visiting? No.
Oh. You know. Honest.
Just bullshitting, hanging out, chilling with family.
That's fine. You have to have time to do that, too, so it's fine. Yeah. It's totally fine. Wow. So, well, family originally from the mainland?
You know, we're from Samoa. Well, my dad... from Samoa. My mom's from San Diego.
Okay.
He joined the army from San Diego. Traveled a little bit before we made Hawaii our home.
Oh, got it. Okay. Mm-hmm. When did you arrive here? How long ago was that? Like, how old were you doing?
It was a long time ago. Yeah, I'm pretty old.
Yeah, good enough. Don't worry. We're an old kind of show. Don't worry. We're fine.
School night.
We do. It's a school night. I mean, it's, you know.
It is a school night.
So the way it's quite all right. It's quite all right. Wow. So from that then, for all the traveling, what was the time? Let's go with that. You decided singer. When did this happen? When did this click for you?
Gosh, maybe later in my adulthood. Yeah. I've always wanted to be a singer when I was younger, but yeah. Grew up in life, and so my trajectory has sort of shifted towards having a career,
yeah,
and supporting children. And it wasn't until a little later where, I decided to pursue it more.
Was that like, around 2006 or mid-2000s? Or when did this kind of become a serious thing?
2006 I was singing.
Yeah.
I was recording then. I was doing a lot of background vocals for my brother, who was a rapper, and... just experimenting.
Yeah, that was like the first track that you did, right? Where you did something for your brother. Where that was like just like a chorus or something or whatnot. Yeah. Don't worry, the lights are hot. Yes. Welcome to my world. Okay. Why I wear dark colors? Okay. Yeah. Hashtag paper towel. Okay. The soul that you would portray in your singing, just amazing. It takes me back to like the olden days of. Maybe like not the older days, but like early 80s or the 70s of contemporary Hawaiian, like Honolulu City Lights, of things of that nature, right. Kalapana, that kind of stuff, right? You don't really hear that now. You have like a lot of the Hawaiian stuff. You have a lot of that kind of style that's kind of evolved. So that's the thing that I credit you to.
Wow.
How did you develop and keep that kind of vibe going through the years, music-wise?
That's a good question. That's a good question. A good question, and no one's ever asked me that.
Oh, okay, sorry.
But
you got the whiskey. Okay.
What would I accredit that to? Of course. See, growing up, I've listened to a lot of music that my parents were listening to at the time.
Okay. Yeah.
I grew up in the 70s, so of course my dad listened to a lot of Kalapana. Some C&K.
Yeah.
They also listened to a lot of 70s, so and some Motown.
Yeah.
So We had a lot of Stylistics, Temptations, Shy Lights, all of that music going on in the house. And even like some stuff from the early 80s, my Atlantic Star. Yeah. And the, oh, got a little bit of funk, the Gap Band. I remember right. all that stuff playing.
The influences are there, yeah.
My so influences were there. And, yeah. And probably some of the stuff that I grew up listening to as well on yeah. the radio. I mean, I listened to a lot of stuff from the 90s.
What's your favorites from the 90s as far as like...
Oh, God. I'd say SWV.
There you go. Shout
they
out.
They were my yeah. favorite group ever.
Shout out, yeah. Shout
it's
out
About SWV. Time. It's like yeah. my favorite album. I've played it for years. Album. Yeah.
So great
maybe,
stuff.
Maybe like Week.
Oh, that was played all the time. Yeah. All the time.
That was the jam. Yeah, Week and Always On My Mind. You're Always On My right? Mind. That was a great song.
Right Here, Human Nature.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I mean,
oh yeah.
So many hits on that.
A lot of hits. Shout
and
out SWV.
Anything. I loved when they did it.
Oh, like, Wu-Tang.
Yeah. Oh. Above the Rim soundtrack.
Oh, that see. Hey. Yeah. We're old, everyone.
I know.
So it's fine. So then, and of course, I get Erykah Badu. You got the Jill D'Angelo. Scott's, D'Angelo's.
Right. You know, Amel LaRue.
Right, Groove Theory. Right. Yeah. That was just a unique time where you had like that type of R&B, you had two different styles of R&B where you'd have the SWV would be like the party vibe. Mm-hmm. And then you have a Groove Theory that would just come out of nowhere. That would be just so smooth. And Maxwell, like your entrance music, like interesting, like how, right? You get entrance music. And it's always just a different vibe that it created this thing that I guess evolved into we call Neo-Soul.
Neo-Soul.
Right? It was like a late 90s.
Yep.
Like how did that... further influence your music as you move from SWV to now you have the neo soul sound.
Right. So neo soul big influence I think it starts from there neo soul.
Yeah.
And then you start digging deeper.
Right.
Like what were these guys listening to? And what were these guys sampling?
You know. Right. It was very hip hop influence where you sample and it was. You didn't really see that, you know, for R&B songs.
And then, you start listening to Erykah Badu, and next thing you know, you listen to Miles Davis.
Right.
Or, you know, some Chaka Khan.
Right, shout out, yeah. So, we went back to 2006. Now, we got to shout out the Slap Symphony.
Oh.
Right? Shout them out, right? James, right? Westbrook.
James, buddy, what?
So, that's kind of, did that get the ball rolling for you as far as working with them, the next phase?
Ooh, that was... Yeah, that I think Slap. They were.
What was the song you did? Was that
we did a song called With You?
Was that it? Okay.
Yeah.
And then. He's gonna bust into that. Really. I'll let you go if you want to do it. Okay. Sorry.
If the spirit moves
back
you.
Back in my day.
Sorry, no. Okay.
Working with Slap, it was very instrumental as to what I wanted to do. As a musician, never thought of myself as a musician.
Yep.
Or a singer, or a creative.
You just enjoyed what you were doing.
Yes.
That was
it. Until they threw me a track, and I was like, okay, let me see if I could write to this, and wrote something, laid it down, and.
And there you go.
Yeah.
And that led to here we are, and
here we are.
We go into then from there. Well, and then also performance-wise, like, let's not forget there was a concert. 2010, 2011, Black Star performed at Hawaii Theater.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
You were there?
Yep, I did. I got to open for Black Star.
A hip-hop concert at Hawaii Theater was like unheard of. Back, like, you know, you're supposed to wear like a blazer or something, right? Like, Drama, you wear a suit? Shout out DJ Drama's here. We're supposed to wear like a blazer at this, right?
And
like,
he
blazer
said never.
With like, you know, sneakers. Okay. But like, that was the one that you opened.
I opened.
Yeah.
And I'm digging into the memory bank because that was a while ago.
Yeah. Like, was that 2010? 2011?
I think it was 2011.
2011? Yeah. Okay.
But yeah, I remember, you know what? It was great. I remember, I remember Slap Symphony was there. We was all backstage.
Yeah.
Going out, doing my song. I think I did a couple songs.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it was over like that.
Oh, yeah. That's how it works, right? I could totally, but it's all a blur, right?
Right.
But it's just a perfect opening for a group like Black Star. That's a historic performance in itself because, you know, who knows when they're going to even reunite or anything at this point. But monumental performance, monumental concert. Here you were at this. And you usually don't have an R&B singer open
right.
for the hip hoppers. So That's a big one.
Huge. That was probably one of my, one of the bigger shows I've done.
Right. Was it like, did you do like a, who else was here? Was Jean Grey here? Were you doing that one?
Yes.
Did you open for that, Jean Grey?
I got to open for
that's Natural Jean Resource.
Wow. And Mr. Len.
Wow.
Shout out underground stuff. But I remember, I think your name was there. Okay, so I'm trying to dig into things here. Okay, so once again, hip-hop show. You have an R&B singer. So we're breaking the mold down, and it's basically, Neil Soul's basically with the hip-hop beats over the singing. So perfect. opening eyes, opening the genre up. And then, so that was around 2011. Let's fast forward then to 2015.
Okay.
That's going. Okay, dig in the memory here in this one. So is that the year you won the Hoku?
Yes.
Okay.
2015.
And that was for which album?
For Waking Up, best R&B album.
Yes, and you also won an award in New Zealand.
Yes.
The People's Choice Award in New Zealand. It's crazy.
Yeah, Vodafone.
Unbelievable. Like, and then you were also on the UK Soul Chart.
Oh yeah.
You were number four in the UK. So this is amazing. So like, what is going through your mind as you see this kind of stuff? Here you are on Hawaii and you see this going, I guess we call it going viral, not really saying that back then, but getting it out there internationally. Yeah, that's amazing. How does that even, someone hears it and someone goes, and it's like a trickle down effect? Or did you know how it got so prominent up there?
Gosh. The UK, let's see. The DJs out in the UK, you know, a lot of the music out there. I feel like the listeners, they kind of set the tone.
Yeah.
They know the goods. They usually, and the DJs, they'll spin your stuff if it's good.
Yeah.
A lot of, in most cases, getting charted on or having a chart on the UK Soul Chart.
Right. Europe is always probably, like ahead. Yeah.
They're always like based on.
Once again, the Americans, right? Yeah.
Good, or I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe somebody knew somebody.
See, right? It's see, going viral tips. See, how are you doing? What are you hashtag?
Was it really good? I don't know.
it got there. It's amazing, totally amazing, and. So, I'm a big fan of the R&B, the soul, the neo soul. DJ that in the club, played that in the clubs, big in the early 2000s, mid 2000s. Mm. How do you feel the genre is in 2019, with all this other stuff going on? How are you, pretty much, evolving and sounding fresh at the same time? The roots are there. How do you feel with the evolution where your music is in? The genre that it's in, neo soul, in 2019.
My music or new? Or we're talking?
I think both. I think with how your music is so different than what we think of the norm of 2019, but it sounds so fresh still. It's an amazing combination. So,
thank you.
Because you don't really hear neo soul a lot in 2019.
Oh, 2019. Like, there. Artists. I don't think I would call it neo soul.
Yeah,
it's still soul.
Yeah,
but I mean, we have folks like Daniel Caesar.
Yeah,
there you go, good call. Yeah.
But his second album, he kind of switched it up, right? Because he was
I liked it. He's an artist too, yeah. Right? And he has to at
least like, evolve.
And show his growth. But still, you know, he. It's still soul music.
Yeah. He sold out Republic, dude.
Yeah,
that's right. Sound. A lot of the music out nowadays are inspired by, you know, the music of the 90s and or early 2000s.
You could go Gambino, you know, a lot of ways, right?
Yeah.
That kind of style. So that's the evolution of it, right?
But I don't know as far as my music. It's all the mood for me.
Mm. It is for a lot of
it's
stuff.
A
so
mood.
Yeah, I don't blame you there.
I get it.
You know,
a lot of moods going on. Well,
I have no direction. I just give off a feeling.
Right.
Does anyone really?
So it's what inspires you in that moment, the vibe.
Exactly. Exactly. Well, yes. here's some direction for you. Now, your vinyl release here. Let's pull this up. Okay, so we got this was in November 2017. You recorded this. Was this what?
Yes.
Right, so through Aloha Got Soul. So mm-hmm. shout out Aloha Got Soul.
Shout out Aloha Got
right.
Soul.
Right, that's right. So if you guys don't know, local record label.
Yes.
That's right? Just... If they're on their own path. They're just on their own path with stuff like this. They work with Kurosawa.
Mm-hmm.
That's Roger, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so shout out. And shout out Oliver Twist, who's part of that. You know Oliver Twist? You a friend? Yeah.
You know, I remember back in the day when Oliver Twist used to spin out on at some of the different events here in Chinatown. And
yes.
Fresh Cafe.
Me and him got busted stealing records at K2H. Yeah. So, yeah, just factoid. Shout out Oliver. But yes, he was a guy from back in the day. He's part of Lost Soul. And then we got to go. Speaking of that, Dehan is on this.
Yes.
So Dehan, he did the drums. That's right. He's the drummer.
The drums.
The Dehan Ensemble.
Yes.
Right. So then shout out to him. And this is available, of course, everywhere streaming. But then you got to get the vinyl. I mean, look at this. Like.
Yes.
So I'm gonna ask you a question regarding the vinyl. So I asked the two... disc jockey people, as they call them, before the show, and I asked them. So I wanted to humbly ask you for your autograph on this record.
Okay.
Right? But it's gotcha. But I didn't open it yet. Okay. So it's the plastic. So do I, in your opinion, should I have you sign the plastic, or do I rip the plastic off and have you sign the actual record, thus opening the record? Though. What should I do in this situation, Maryanne?
We can open the plastic,
nicely?
So that, nicely. Oof, don't be all messy about it.
Once again, I'm grumpy, so you know, snap it. I don't know if I can do that nicely, but...
Why did he even ask us, I guess?
You know what? Okay, I'm taking a poll, all right? Okay, so they both said I ripped the plastic off. So I'm ripping the plastic. take a shot. We're going to have you rip the plastic off. I'll rip the plastic off, and then we'll do this. We'll do this after, but... Well, we got to speak before I forget. Nick Kurosawa, you were on the song Midnight Diner. Now, shout out Otoro, Nick Rosal, the latest song, Midnight Diner. You were on there.
Mm.
Great video.
Yeah. Thank you.
Excellent video. Did you ever watch the show?
No.
Okay.
Wait, Midnight Diner.
Yeah, Midnight Diner.
Oh, yes.
Yes, right. Yes. You a fan of the show?
I am.
Great show. I started watching that because of the song and because of the video, because I didn't know when they were showing.
I started watching it because of food.
Well, there's that. Right. Right. So it's a show on Netflix. For people that don't know, it's based off this guy who has a diner that opens mm-hmm. at midnight. It's in Japan, and the show is based off like fried rice omelet.
Oh yeah.
Well, yeah. Whatever the food reflects on what's going
right.
on
and
in people's
then the,
lives
the people,
and their personalities.
They all tell about their lives, and then they culminates in like 20 minutes, and they all look at the camera and they go, "Hey," and they do that. So it's dakimasu. So there's so shout out to that. That was a great one. Also, a lot of stuff at Blue Note you've done over the past year. What talk about the local ladies of Seoul. What's going on with that?
Local ladies of Seoul. Was that a show that we didn't
that have? Was well, Maryanne, it was a show you did in February. you did this great
yes.
show. I tell you, where you did
the
90s covers.
Yes.
You did SWV at the show.
Yes, we did.
Right. Okay. If you sang Week and you didn't remember that, I don't know. Never mind already. But
we did that in February. I did that with Mindy Smokestack, Melody So, and my girl Miley. We covered a bunch of 90s
nice.
Music.
Right. Nice. You're going to do that again? Are we going to have part two of this?
I'm not sure. Maybe.
Okay.
Right. Maybe.
What were some of the artists you covered?
Of course, we did SWV's Week. Nice. We did... Some Mary J. Blige.
Yeah. Tony Braxton in there.
Some Faith Evans.
There you go. Shout out.
We need to add Tony Braxton.
You got to do it. Tony Braxton. That's a favorite of mine.
And some In Vogue.
Oh, yeah.
We were going to do In Vogue, but, you know, In Vogue, their harmonies are so tight, and we got a little scared.
Well, once again, that's what liquor's for. Okay?
Right?
That's what liquor's
for.
That's
why I drink. No, please. kidding.
Well, let's fast forward to this month. You got a friend of yours that's going to be performing in this month?
Aretha. Ooh, yes.
Let's shout her out.
So Paula Funga, my girl Paula.
Yep.
She's does her annual tribute to Aretha Franklin at the Blue Note. I sing backup for her for this show. So this year we're doing two nights at the Blue Note. We're doing Saturday and Sunday night.
What's the dates on those? So we can
the shoots, the 12th and the 13th. The twelfth and the
13th. It's on IG. It's okay. Yes. It's fine. It's all on Instagram.
No, I'm sure. The 12th and the 13th.
Okay. All right.
Just Saturday making sure. The 12th and okay. The 13th.
Shoot. Okay, so if the questions aren't more crazy, we're gonna take it a step further. We have listener questions.
Oh no.
You ready for this one? Okay. First listener question. Are you single?
Oh, I'm not available. We'll just put it like that.
Very good. I like that. You answered.
We'll just put it like that.
Authoritative. I like it. I like it. Okay.
We got issues.
Who's? I love it. Very, very strong answer. Okay, next one. Who's your favorite hip hop artist?
My favorite hip hop artist. Shucks. Oh my goodness.
The rappers.
I know.
I tell you, they rap and you know.
Oh, I don't know.
No, really?
I can't just pick one.
You gotta pick someone? Cedric Clinton. No.
No. Cedric Clinton. No.
Illmatic. Astro Guillotine. A no from Freeze.
Gosh, I don't know.
Really off the top of the really?
I don't think I have one maybe.
Well see none of them set in, none of them are memorable. That's fine. That's fine. Well next question.
Oh, shit.
Next one. Well speaking of rapping, I heard rumors somewhere that you rap as well.
I try to and I'm lucky enough to catch a beat. So but
that's all you need really.
Yeah, you know, I don't see it off limits.
You're not gonna rap in your next track. You know, do like a
maybe.
Yeah, right.
I'm not
turning on this.
Not a rapper, but okay.
All right.
I do a little something.
Oh, see, the fire burns. All right, what is next for you? What's you got coming up for yourself? What's the next performance? Working on anything?
Am I working on anything?
New album soon, or?
I think I'm, I want to say I'm writing, but that's a mood thing. And lately, I've just been chilling. This sounds so bad.
It's the weather.
I'm not sure.
That works.
Not sure.
You know what? It's all moods. And
the mood catches her, then it's going to be
when the mood catches it, we're all kind of not sure.
It's organic, bro. It's organic.
Yeah.
Well, here's something that we would like to see if you are sure about. We're going to play a little game.
Okay.
Where you're going to have to probably be sure about something. Because we're going to play something called...
I'll try to be.
You're going to do the best, I tell you. It's called Who Dis. And it's basically we're going to play Name That Tune where Freeze is going to play a song. And then you guess the artist.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, shit. Okay, do you need another shot? Okay, Freeze,
before,
you ready?
Before we start this, though, I wanted to say something.
There we go.
So... I've known Mary for a while.
Yes.
I've been blessed enough to sit in studio session with her. This was before she got her Hoku because of drama and Sub-Zero. Shout out Prima Phonics.
Oh,
and to actually be sitting there when she's in doing her process is something to behold. It really is. Like,
really?
The way her mind works and the way she comes up with melodies on the fly, that is what is really amazing to me.
Thank you.
So shout out Level Beats, shout out Prima Phonics, because of them, I've been able to sit on many sessions with her. And just to see her mind twerk, I guess. I don't know why that twerk, but just to see her just
mind twerk.
Her mind twerk. It's really amazing. Like yeah. To see her go through different to see her mind go through different riffs. And that she can do it on the fly.
There you go.
It is something to really witness. And I'm so grateful to even have been a part of all of that, you know? So shout out all of y'all.
Nice.
I needed to say that before we try to stump you with these songs.
Good. Good intro.
Nice.
Good intro.
Thank you.
Very nice, Freeze. Let's go hit it.
Oh my gosh, is this Erica
Badu? On fire, just like that. We're done. Yes, one for one. Nice, Erica Badu. Yes. You got the artist, though. You got the artist. That's it. It is Le Nubian. Yes.
Okay.
Taboo. Taboo. Yes.
Okay.
Two for two. Two for two.
Taboo.
It's a favorite of the show.
Corey? Sexual conversation. I know this
one. If you get this, well, the guy's going to get really mad. Company got mad at me.
I don't think I heard this one.
Okay, no guesses. Male singer, this is mid 2000, no, maybe early 2000s. 2004. There's a lot of them. There's a lot of these male singers. No?
No.
That's it? Okay.
All right.
It's Glenn Lewis.
Okay.
Glenn Lewis, back for more with Cardinal Official.
Good one.
So YouTube blocked me from posting. We had Sub-Zero play this game, and we played that song for Sub-Zero. He couldn't get it. Oh, so shout out Sub-Zero for screwing that up. So then we're gonna keep this going.
I don't feel too bad if Sub didn't.
See,
get
Sub
it.
Didn't get it, right, but then yeah. So, but then I'm missing me uploading the episode with Sub. Like, YouTube blocked this song, so YouTube is not down for Glenn Lewis. So
all right.
They're gonna block this right now again.
Maybe they got good reason.
You still win because we're battling the corporate world, so you still are a winner here.
Okay.
So what do we got for the...
Aw. You can't
all day. Woo. See you all day.
Almost
won. What is this, amateur hour?
All
right. You got it. Yes. Four for four.
Okay.
Right? How about it, Freeze, right? All right, let's go and let's get things going because you are going to perform for us. We can't wait. I tell you, this is going to be exciting.
Okay.
Take another shot. We'll do a shot together. Okay, yeah. We'll do a shot together and we perform. Yeah, the Lord is ready already. So let's take a break. But once again, Maryanne Ito, everyone. How about it? Let's take a break. We're back. Maryanne is still here. You all right? We're gonna do a shot after. We're not gonna do one before you perform. Okay, just checking.
We could wait.
Okay, we're gonna wait.
We'll do it after.
But before then, once again, Maryanne Ito.
Thank you so much. Shout out to Dayhan. This is a song called I Met Your Rep. Electrified, impressed by your display. Will it intensify, or will the novelty fade? Mean what you say, but you convey. Oh, I'm questioning if this is real or if it's true. Wondering, struggling to unshoe. If you mean what you say, yeah. Are you who you portray? Oh, yeah. But we got that bit of it, we got that bit of it, we see the real you. Do I have to put back countless days? Wanna know what's that? I wanna see your truth. But will you let me, let me, let me, will you let me, let me see the real you? Is it what you want for me to go along? I wanna know your truth. I'm sure you'd like to display your qualities. Well, I'm past the hype. I wanna dig down underneath. Past was glamorized. Your good looks so good, boy. If I look in your eyes, will I see your chosen way? I'm intrigued and charmed. You're sweet as marmalade. Should I be alarmed that this could be a masquerade? That means what you say. Ooh, do you portray? Ooh. Thank you. Shout out to Sleep Time's Over, DJ Zach Morris. Is that a Saved by the Bell reference?
Correct.
I love that show. Jesse Gonzalez, that was my girl. Hey, most of my problems would go away. Most of my troubles. I could care less about the things I hear, baby. I should meditate more to keep my mind clean. I've been trying to beat someone's expectation over a sham misrepresentation of who I am, what I'm about. The funny thing is that I'm still finding out. I run my own pace, go at my own pace, choke my game and construct new lanes. Learn as I go, so much to know. Digging into my untapped potential, I'm just growing. And it feels so sensational. I'm free to grow, I just got to let go. We'll do the verse again. Most of my problems will go away. Most of my troubles will disappear. Most of my troubles will disappear. If I could care less about the things I hear, maybe I should meditate more to keep my mind clear, my mind clear, my mind clear. I was trying to meet someone's expectation. It was a sham misrepresentation of who I am, what I'm about. The funny thing is that I'm still finding out. I'll go my own pace, at my own race, constructing new lanes, and I'm soaking up game. Learn as I grow, there's so much to know. I'm digging into my untapped potential. I'm just growing, 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 yeah, yeah. I'm growing, growing, growing. Thank you. Shout out to Jim Hurdle. And shout out to Letty Let. Letty Let, please get better. Love you.
Maryanne Ito, everyone. Oh. Fire. Fire. Thank you. Literally, right there, fire. Okay, yeah. All right, yes, these lights, I know. I know. Good thing we're wearing dark colors. All right, let's get out of here. Shout out everyone that at the Hi Brau tonight. Shout out all yourselves. Shout out the Hi Brau Room. Shout out to the Lord. Shout out DJ Freeze. How about it, right? DJ Freeze, Sky Cameron, Kale. Once again, the sound. If it's no more sound, that's it. Jane Ads on the IG. The social media. How about it? We out here. We out here. Sakai and Company. We got Calamansi, Calamense. Potato, potato. And then shout out everybody. We're going to be here next week. Curacao is going to be here. Osna's going to be here. Marinito's here right now. Sleep time's over. Good night.